Hey fish friends, how's it going? I hope you're doing well. Zenzo from Tazawa Tanks. In the last video, I talked about how I was inspired by another person's Fishroom. That video, and I'll put a link of it right up here, that was Primetime Aquatics Fishroom. I saw it when we visited his fishroom when I was in Chicago for Aquashella. And it was really a very interesting fishroom. It was really set up to kind of just hang out, lounge around, and it was just very inviting. And I talked about this in the last video. Anyway, in that last video, I talked about how my fish room wasn't really working for me. It was too cramped feeling, too small, and I needed to make some changes in order for me to enjoy myself down here a lot more. Well, I made those changes. I spent all day working yesterday, and I'm gonna show you guys what I did. So, what I did is I changed my fish room. Now, basically it's the same setup, so most of the tanks are where they were, but you might recall basically where I'm standing now, there was a wall. I guess the tank was here and there was like a wall right behind here. And I pushed this wall back. So back behind me, there is a wall and I built that. So essentially before what I had is I had like some PVC kind of hanging from the ceiling and I had like a tarp and then I had some insulation in front of that tarp. And so it was kind of like a heavy duty insulated curtain. And what that was doing is that was basically creating kind of a barrier for moisture, for warmth, etc. So it was kind of trapping all the heat in this room, and that was essentially the wall for the fish room. Well, I didn't love the setup. It wasn't very permanent, obviously. And there were some issues with having to get in and out of this fish room. You had to kind of like pull the curtain back, and it was a real hassle. Anytime I had anyone visiting, anytime I had to come in and out of the fish room, I'd always have to kind of climb through this flap in the door, kind of like getting in and out of a tent. So I decided to make the room bigger by building a real wall. So what I did is I built a wall. It's obviously not load bearing, but it is a 2x4 framed wall with plywood on the outside for the siding. And then on the inside, I have this insulation board. And what that did is it gave me more space in this fish room. It allowed me to basically be able to stand and turn around in a circle and not touch anything. So I'm super excited about that because before it was really claustrophobic and cramped in here. So now there's a lot more room. In addition to having more room, I can kind of enjoy the tanks more because before, like the wall that was right here, I couldn't really enjoy the Mbuna tank or the Congo tank. And it was really hard to kind of navigate around and see some of the tanks and see the fish. Well, now there's nothing obstructed. Everything is kind of open. So it allows me to see them more, to enjoy them more, easier to feed, easier to service, but most importantly, just fun to hang out down here. I also put down kind of a little carpet down here. I wanted it to be obviously something that can get wet because underneath it's a concrete floor. And when I'm doing water changes, you know, water can spill from time to time. So I wanted it to be something that was resistant to water. So basically it's like an outdoor carpet, something that you would use like on your patio or like when you go camping or in front of your RV or something like that. So you can hose it off, vacuum it, whatever. But it does kind of create kind of a nice environment in here. I can sit on the floor if I want to. I think I might try to put some seating in here. I'm not sure what I want to do. I do have a couple of chairs that might work, but I kind of feel like they would get in the way, so maybe like a bean bag or something. I don't know. Let me know down below what you think I should do as far as seating. Should I just leave it alone? Should I put a bench in here? Give me your thoughts. Now, one of the other things that I did is there was a couple of tanks that were set up just for like growing out fry and stuff like that. And they're basically right here behind me now. So we've got the 37 and there's a 20 gallon underneath. And I scaped the 37 with rock work and crushed coral and sand. And that is the Brichardi tank. So I do have Brichardi upstairs, but now I have them downstairs as well. So they're enjoying it as well. And a lot more space for them. And they did spawn in a 20 gallon earlier, but the fry didn't make it because they probably got eaten. So I'm hoping with more rock work and a little bit larger tank, the fry will survive. Now they do spawn upstairs. These are actually all fry that I had spawn upstairs that grew out, so I moved them down here. The other thing that I did, and you may have noticed just from maybe seeing behind me, maybe not, is I moved the two baby Oscars. Now I bought these Oscars, I think back in July. It's October now, so they've like doubled in size. When I got them, they were pretty small. They're about yay big now. And I put them in with my other Oscar named Felix. Now Felix is a very large Oscar cichlid. He's probably around 11 or 12 inches long, so he is quite large. Now the two smaller Oscars are a lot smaller, obviously. They're still young, they're growing. They do have tremendous appetites, but they get along quite well. I was kind of worried at first as far as like, you know, am I gonna have to separate them, put in a barrier? And I said, what the heck, let me just do it. So what I did is I did a giant water change on this 125, and I had to because I had to move it back about 3 feet. So I did a giant water change. When I did that, I put a bunch of water in a garbage can. I caught Felix, I put him in the garbage can in the water, and then I moved the tank, and then I put the two smaller Oscars in the tank again, moved some stuff a little bit around a tiny bit, and then put Felix back in as I was refilling, and they got along just well. So at first they were kind of like not sure about it, but they've been basically just kind of like following each other around the whole time. So at first Felix wasn't quite sure. He was kind of like hiding behind a rock or eyeballing them. And then finally he's just like, he came out, he just doesn't pick on them, and they just kind of all swim around together like a trio. So hopefully it maintains that way. I'm very happy so far. No aggressions, no issues. They've been eating, they're active. And I'm happy because Felix does seem to be more social now than he was before after we lost Oscar. So there you go, that is the fish room. I did want to make it a little bit more aesthetically pleasing. I did kind of like hide some of my stuff that I have stored in here with some wood, and I wanted it just to be kind of a better place for me to hang out, chill, look at my fish, watch YouTube videos, chillax. You know, winter's coming, and even though I live in California, it doesn't get super cold here, but you know, there will be colder days, and it's fun to come down here where it's 80 degrees in the fish room. I can just hang out in shorts and a t-shirt and watch some YouTube videos and just hang out with my fish. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And ooh, a big bonus to someone who could guess why I'm wearing 49ers gear. So I'm wearing 49ers hat, I'm wearing a 49ers t-shirt. Now the obvious reason is I live in San Francisco and I'm a 49er fan, got it. But there's another reason why I'm wearing 49er gear, and it has to do with the last video. So you'll wanna go back and watch that other video of me visiting Primetime Aquatics, see if you can find out the connection. That's all I had for now. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to give it a big like. We'll catch you on the next one.